Okay, thank you. Welcome to the 2021 8th International Conference on Electrical Engineer, Computing Science and Automatical Control. We are at room 3 and we are going to start with the first presentation, a new position algorithm robust to measure distance errors for no overdetermined systems by Luis Ángel Arellano Cruz, Giselle Montserrat Galván Tejada and Rogelio Lozano Leal. You have 15 minutes. The clock is visible in the application. And do you want? And you have 15 minutes for the presentation and 5 minutes for the questions. Go ahead, Luis Arellano.
Okay. Thank you. I can share the. Okay, I start the presentation. Good morning, everyone. My name is Luis Ángel Arellano Cruz, and I am here to present the article which name is a new positioning algorithm robust to measure distances errors for non-overdetermined systems. The authors of this article is Giselle Galván Tejada, Rogelio Lozano, and me. The content of this presentation is the following: introduction, positioning algorithm, simulation settings, results, conclusion, and reference. As is well known, the positioning system is very important for navigation applications, mainly for unmanned aircrafts. And in the case of indoor scenarios, there are some strategies. One of them is the use of ultra-wideband positioning systems due to the high accuracy in the estimation. One of the problems with this kind of technology is in scenarios with multiple obstacles due to the radio propagation is affected by the obstacles and signal delay is introduced in these cases. In order to obtain a position estimation into a 2D space, it is necessary a minimum of 3 reference stations or anchors. Okay. It's necessary a minimum of 3 reference stations or anchors. It's all okay. It normally is recommended the use of overdetermined systems. Which means 4 anchors or more. However, there is cases where there is no possible count with a grid number of anchors, you only have the minimum required. For these specific cases, a new algorithm based on ultra-wideband technology for position estimation was proposed in this article. Okay. Normally, the trilateration method is able to estimate the position solving a system of equations with a minimum of 3 equations. Only is necessary know the position of each anchor and the distance between the each anchor and the UAV need to be measured. These measured distance have errors. For that is necessary at least 3 equations in order to estimate the position of the objective. However, if these errors are too large, the It is possible that the system, system equations don't have a solution. For that reason, it's recommended the use of a thermal system in order to avoid that that situation, because if the system of equations don't have a solution, it is difficult to find the position of the target. For that reason, in this article, we propose the RAGN algorithm. That is because we make use of the radical axis and Gauss-Newton method for estimate the position in that specific cases. The underlying idea of the proposed algorithm is to take the solution generated by the radical axis method as a first approximation of the position to be introduced as initial value of the Gauss-Newton method. It's important to say that the radical axis method is able to obtain the a possible position where the errors respect to the three anchors are equivalent. However, the errors in the reality no are equivalent. For that is possible is the most probably is that the first estimation has low accuracy. For that, the objective of the Gauss-Newton method is find the position where the errors respect to the three anchors are minimum. In other words, the Gauss-Newton optimizes the position, minimizing the errors. This is achieved evaluating with a cost function. In this paper, we use as cost function the root mean square error with the equation here presented. Okay, in order to evaluate the algorithm proposed, we develop a simulation where a UAV and three anchors are deployed in a random position into a square area, which dimensions are of 30 meters by side, and the measured distance between each anchor and the UAV have a random variation. This variation is taken as the mean value of a Gaussian distributed random variable. This is important with a standard deviation of 0.5 meters. Due to this, represents the error for multipath environments. In the case of Gauss-Newton method, we use two different initial values, the origin and the center of the area. And the error tolerance values is set up in 0.001. The results obtained after 10,000 simulation runs was compared and analyzed using the cumulative distribution function in terms of root mean square error. And we can observe that in the case of the RAGN algorithm, the probability of 90% is that the error is less than 10 centimeters. Compared with the other methods, is a significant improvement. We can observe the radical axis have a probability of the error is about 150 centimeters, and in the case of Gauss-Newton, with initial value in the center of the area is 220 centimeters, and in the initial value in the origin is the 40 centimeters. With that, we also demonstrate that the importance of the initial value. If we have a better initial condition, in this case using the radical axis as first approximation, the accuracy of the estimation will be with a high accuracy. Similarly, we analyze the errors in terms of the errors estimation compared the the estimation position respect to the real position. Also in terms of the cumulative distribution function, and we have the probability of 90% is the error is lower than 40 centimeters, which is really low or lower compared with the other methods. Okay, as conclusion of this presentation, we can say that this work presents an algorithm based on radial axis and Gauss-Newton method, able to estimate the position when an overdeterminate system are not available. And by simulation, we can demonstrate that the performance of the proposed algorithm is able to compensate the position errors, combining the characteristic of the two methods, and the accuracy is higher compared to the performance of each method working separately. And this is it for me, and thanks for your attention.
Thank you, Luis. If you have any questions or comments, you can write in the chat, or if you want, you can open your yes. Any questions in the chat? No. Okay. So, well, thank you for your presentation, Luis. We will continue with the other presentation. Thank you. We'll continue with the presentation. Collision free path planning applying robotics arms using homotopy continuation methods for embedded systems. The presentation is ready. The presentation. Okay, Gerardo, are you ready?
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay. Can you share your presentation?
Yes. One moment.
Thank you. Yes, we will. Okay.
Can you see?
No, I don't see your presentation yet.
Excuse me one moment.
Yes, take your time.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Can you see?
Not yet.
Presentation?
Yeah. Right. Presentation? Yeah. Yeah. Now I can see it.
Okay. 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 I start?
Yes, you can start. Go ahead.
Okay.
Thank you.
Perfect. Okay. Hello. Good morning. My name is Gerardo Vélez. I will present the work that is named Collision Free Path Planning Applied Robotic Arms Using Homotopic Continuation Methods for Embedded System. The content of the presentation is followed. I will start with motivation. I will continue with the brief explanation of the homotopic continuation method, followed by explanation of the homotopic path planning method. In addition, the strategy using the two model robotic R will display. The case study will be shown, and finally, I will present the conclusion. Robotics is an area where we can find mobile robots, robotics are humanoid, etc. To be able to use them safely in the autonomous or semi-autonomous environment, this robot needs path planning algorithms to be able to move from the A position to B position without colliding with any obstacle present in the workspace. In particular, this work focuses on robotic arms, which are elements we daily use in various areas, such as research, industry, medicine, even in collaborative work with humans, as can be seen in the image. Currently, there are techniques used to solve path planning problems. Next, I will quickly show you some of the most used. Rapid Exploring Random Trees, or RRT, is a method that creates a tree and grows randomly, which is to unit starting position with the goal, as shown in the figure. Here, the robot arm moves along the path found by RRT method. Probably roadmaps. Roadmap is created by joining three nodes in the second stage. In the second stage is a query where it is supported algorithms such as Dijkstra or A-star. In particular, A-star algorithm seeks to find the shortest path between the starting point and the goal. The A-star algorithm is also path planning method, is a heuristic, and has been modified in order to attain better results. Creating algorithms like on anything repairing. I start. This method need to store all their nodes for the reason higher memory consumption is required. The computational cost depends on the heuristic used. They also need a smoothing of the path if they have problem working in the narrow corridor. That is why need arise a proposed more efficient algorithm. Now I will talk about the homotopic continuation method. This is what initially developed to solve the nonlinear algebraic equation system and uses the following equation, where we seek to solve the function the function f of r from now function g of r. In addition, the lambda parameter. The homotopy creates a path or trajectory will start from the initial state and they will in the solution when lambda is equal one. Next, an example of existing nonlinear equation solved with the homotopy continuation method will be shown. This system has three solutions or roads. In the figure one, it is observed how a path or trajectory is created, which cross the plane finding the three solutions of the system equation, which show wing green dots. The figure two show the solution were found when lambda equals one. The homotopy path planning method takes advantage of the trajectory created by homotopy continuation method and use it to generate collision-free path. Now, understand the method proposed in this work, I will talk about the homotopy path planning method. This method models the obstacle equation. Here, the equation using for circular obstacle is shown. This method creates singularities with a set of obstacles, as shown in the equation. W here, pi subscribe a, I represent the repulsion parameter. Of B subscribe I the obstacles. Q remote effect the W by evaluation in the goal point. In addition, outside the equation based in equation or the straight line are using from the homotopy system and the Y implementation is as follows. Where I can be seeing that in the fusion F2, W and Q are implicit. The homotopy path planning method requires an spherical tracking algorithm that follows the homotopy path all times. It's based in spiral spheres and uses predicted corrector exchange. Here can see how the periphera imposition on the homotopy trajectory. The periphery equation to function is followed. The predictor creates point in the circumference on the peripheral close of the homotopy trajectory, and the corrector adjusts the value in the order position itself of the trajectory. The periphera is updated in each iteration until we reach lambda equal one, where we can say that we have reached the goal. As a predictive algorithm, the Euler or vector method can be used, and Braided method was used as a corrected algorithm. Now, I will talk about the modeling of the robotic arm. The geometric model was used for the kinematic representation is based in representation design and cosines. I can be seen in the figure. The image shown to lean robotic arm. And this equation describes position of the limbs on robotic arm. Now, to get rigidity on the links on the robotic arm and strategy of singular projection, what used? Where each link has a number n of projection of each of the obstacles presented in the board space. I can be seen in the figure. In the example, in the link S is subscribed to has a number n of the singular projection with the two obstacle circle. Circular obstacle. The created projection, the projection of this link, the following equation is using, which will be added to equation that model the kinematics of the link. AS subscribe, do remaining. Now the equation represents singularities is the following. Where A represents the number of the singular projection for a link, for each link. B is in the number. B is the number of that link that robotic R has, and U is the total number of obstacles present in the workspace. Now the repulsion parameter is represented by pi subscribe u and ov subscribe tjk represent obstacles. Now the question for circular obstacle is as follows. The auxiliary equation. The auxiliary equation will have the following format with an equation I needing for each link, obtaining the following system of equation. The system of equation to be solved is the one shown below. Here it can be seen that the peripheral equation was added and the homotopy used is Newton's. Now, I will show two case studies. In an inbound workspace, you have three obstacles. Obstacles C2 and C3 for a narrow corridor. The robotic arm used has three links of the same length and black gripper. The joints are marked with green dots. The initial position of the robot arm is colored in red, and the desired final position is displayed in blue. In the first case study, initial, the robot arm is contracted. I move extend until it reaches the obstacle C1. In the second scenario, at the beginning, the robotic arm is holding the obstacle C1. It must be released and then take again. Now, I will show you third case study where the robot arm used obtain to final position or goals while avoiding the two obstacle, the circular obstacle. The final position are shown in blue and yellow. Here the robotic arm has three links with their different lengths. Now I will show you table where a computation times and the RAM memory you see in the trick case study show at observed. The hardware characteristic of the personal computer and embedded system is as shown. The record time are of the order millisecond and in all cases less than half a second. In addition, the RAM memory used is of the order kilobytes. The proposed method was programmed in the C++ language. In a show, we mentioned that mathematical library or strategy should a multi-trend were not used obtain the result show. Furthermore, if this method will be evaluated in workstation, the computation time will decrease considerably.
Hi Gerardo, if you can, the time is limited and I don't know if you can conclude your presentation. Thank you.
Okay. Conclusion. As conclusion, we can say following way. In this method, it's not necessary to calculate the forward inverse kinematics. Since the initial and final position are defined, not needing post-processing or path smoothing, work well in a narrow corridor. The calculation times are less than 1 second, as well as the RAM memory is the order of the kilobytes. The method allows modeling hyper-redundant R and with different time grouper. Also, this method I can see stems 3D workspace. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Gerardo. Well, we invite you to write your questions in the chat, please, or a commentary that you wish to share. Any questions? Well, very interesting topic, Gerardo, and thank you for your presentation. We will continue with the next presentation. Thank you. The presentation toward a single pixel near infrared low resolution to the mesh reconstruction strategy. Yes, it's ready.
Good morning. I can see the presentation.
Yes.
Well,
okay. It's not presented. It's like the application, the PowerPoint application.
Yes.
It's not a presentation. I don't know if you want.
Okay. You can see it?
It's still the application. I can see it, but it's the PowerPoint application, not the presented version. I don't know if you.
Okay, I start.
Can you open your video, please? Your camera.
You need to start the presentation. Then after that, you need to share that window.
Oh yes. No, it's not. If you can pause the sharing, yes, stop the sharing, and then start the presentation and then share that presentation, yes?
moment. I compartí en la presentación. No?
Yes, but it's still the application. It's like, it's not presented. I don't know if
we are still watching the PowerPoint editor. You need to start the presentation. Then after that, share it.
Now, moment. Yes. You can see it.
I can see, but if you can stop the presentation, I don't know how to say it. The share, stop the share. Then.
Yeah. One more moment.
Yes.
Drawing this version of the.
I know.
Okay.
Yeah. Now start the presentation in your computer.
Okay.
And then go to Teams and then share it. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Now.
Oh. Okay. Now you're sharing your full desktop. If you want to share that, it's okay. But just share your camera, please.
You can see now presentation in a moment or have problem you see it.
I see your full desktop. That's what I see, yeah? If you start the presentation like that, we will see the presentation. But we don't see you in the camera. That's what is missing.
No moments. Use it or?
Yes, but it's still the application.
I have a problem with the version of my PowerPoint.
Yes, but it still can you present it, no, and share the presentation. Because we see your presentation, but in the editor. Yes. Not in presented form.
You have problems. My computer is only show the editor.
It doesn't show the presentation then.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay. When I begin.
Can you open your camera, please?
Yes.
My name is Carlos Osorio.
Sorry, your camera, it's not on. Can you open your camera, please?
I can open the camera because our problem in my project is person. I have problem techniques, my computer, with my camera.
Okay, go ahead.
My name is Carlos Osorio. I present of the Tower single picture and infrared low resolution to the imaging reconstruction strategies.
Sorry, just the presentation, it's not centered. I'm sorry. It's missing some
moments.
Yes.
Now, no see it.
It's like I know you can see it. It's like it's just the low half. Yeah, half. It's missing some part in the presentation because it's not seen. I can see the full title of the presentation. So it will be missing some information if you continue. just reduce the zoom in the application.
Okay.
Yes. In order to, yes. Like in the bottom. Yeah. Yeah. Right now.
No. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Sorry. Okay, when I start.
Not so small, maybe a little bit more bigger just to see it, but that's all. Thank you.
Okay. I start. Okay.
Yes, continue. Thank you, Carlos.
I tower and the Seeger Pixar near for a low solution to imagine a reconstruction extract. The content of the section introduction, a brief description of the single pixel of your reconstruction, applying the algorithm for generation parameters, region projection applied to near speed, evaluation to method hammer region projection and near speed, our new vision system for a UiBit conclusion and question. Well, the operation single pixel based one on the projection sequence hammer parameters over the earlier what you like to photograph. The projection behavior is similar to having an array and end pixel. Is a curvy consideration has an array end to end virtual pixel. The light projection parameter captured by photodetector reconstruction using some different compressing sensing algorithms. The reconstruction algorithm that can operate a few samples can be used in parallel and be adapted to some architecture GPU. Behind you, GPU and architecture adapter for pairing using operating mainly for reconstruction, imaging, and video. The single piece of reconstruction for energy imaging, we have array LED, the projection and sequencing pairing by Hammer via the capture by a photodetector, the conversion of the signal light and electrical signal. While processing using reconstruction algorithms, the reconstruction that imaging using visual imaging and sequencing hammer, the accuracy in the imaging of depending on the sign, the number of parameters. In case of the A2A site, we can see a lower reconstruction, the imaging high spatial resolution. We have the detail observer, the reconstruction is poor, it will apply on the higher accuracy. The playing algorithm parameters, the proper Hammer Palmer generation via the objects. The after loss custom measure, the primary line using the matrix EPS will define areas or sequence via the change in the sequencing Hammer Palmers. If the parameter is a construction or throughout the imaging using mutation operation as the recorder, we generation a new sequence of the sequence Palmer. The sequencing are here and using HPEA algorithms. The current projection sequencing of the 64 PAMs divided into 16 groups, contact force elements, the projection sequence, and the defining iron projection. The algorithms evaluate on the different sequencing, a switch on off sequencing in the Hammer projection using the vector bit. With the production position binary of the group, defines what is the sequencer with the chains in the Hammer projection. For evaluation Hammer region, we design an experimental setup. We define the text, simulates on the collision, simulates on the background lights, noise, experimentance activation in the wetlands, 215 nanometer at the configuration back modulation, the test and the continuous illumination background, the line intensities between the 0 and 15 lux, similar situation on the outdoor scenario. In this area, in the ties, the semi direction using the text base, using different scanning methods based on the projection basis, the Hammer, and different packs. The projection Hammer patterns. For the variation regions, we define those two types of the objects. One object is spherical calibration, the distance of the test and the 20 centimeter the focal length using different scanning methods, buses, hero packs, zigzag, and spears. We can see for the meriting parameter, SEM, symmetry reimagining, using now BASIT using GEA algorithm and only projection. You can see different improve in the Maillard reconstruction. Now here is very, very ancient in the margins. And similar tests using the piece neural reader for determining the noise in the margin on the condition the light background. Another comparison is the time in the reconstruction in the probing application in the method of the region projection Hadamard. You can see different scanning methods, from BASIT to SPEAR. You can see improvements in the percentage between in the seat and 20 improvement rates. The zigzag and SPEAR, zigzag and here, I can improve in the image application. And around 20 improve in the right. Now in the application in using object the test, fairy objects, you can see in spear and here is province. SPA, a new vision system UAV. SPA, a new concept application como has a sensor vision. Now been in improving using infrared over visual spectrum camera is improving quality imaging over a scenario with low vision on the foot and range, navigation environment in with low illumination and with dispersion using EPS, the environment to application mapping or navigation, integration and reduction vision for application reduction on the search reef assistance. Conclusion, with the improving in the parameter SEIN height 0.6 and peak scenario rise 28 dB. In comparison with all the Hadamard modification, we are requires also and 3 milliseconds or more percentile speed and hybrid base scanning method combination with Hadamard region production yield the best performance in the near SPA to image reconstruction. Here and CSA method using behind in the faster one and the speed based on the slowness. The ability to have processing time below 30 milliseconds. A single piece imaging allows to increasing to single piece vision system capacity with potential application UAV. So, question?
Thank you for your presentation. If anyone has a question, please write it on the chat. And I just want to have a question. I don't know. You have these processing times improvement, but I don't know if I miss it. But in which environment? CPU, GPU, desktop, an embedded computer. Which system it was?
What is the difference in the time, the processing time?
Yes.
Bueno, en el momento, the embedded system using GPU, JSON Nano integrated. I have a difference in the comparison entre CPU and to GPU. I have different time around the 10 times. The GPU accelerate the processing around the 3 or 4 time in comparison with and the CPU. Now moment is a system vision start is compared using their GPU integrates by architecture of the hardware and the optical for compacter device to integrate into UVS.
Okay. And if you ask, I don't know, if someone to have to integrate this this algorithm to an embedded system, and where the time is really, really important, which of the algorithms that you show will implement as a recommendation?
The recommendation, this is one of the broad concepts in that moment, okay? Around the recommended time processing below 14 milliseconds. This is time around is the frame to send around those 10 frame for seconds. Okay. And a moment in the literature proposed the time reconstruction below the 14 milliseconds to application and real to near to real time. Sorry, I can. I have a problem in the audio.
Yes, my audio. Sorry. Okay. Thank you so much, Carlos, for your presentation, and we will continue with the next presentation. Thank you. The present. Then we will continue with the presentation developed of an efficient path planning algorithm for indoor navigation. Okay, thank you. Can you open your camera, please?
Excuse me. Yes. I can share my video camera.
Oh, okay.
Because it's for the presentation. I don't know why.
Okay, you have some technical issues. Okay, then are you ready to start? Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Good morning.
Thank you.
The presentation is named Development on Efficient Path Planning Algorithm for Indoor Navigation. The contents of this presentation is the introduction, the peer method, the proposed method, the simulation and results, and the conclusion and future work. Okay, one of the tasks of autonomous vehicles is the navigation, which consists in making of the mobile robot go from one place to another without the intervention of the operator. For this problem, the methods generally include the path planning and trajectory following task, which complement each other. For this, some definition are shown in the next. The path planning determines the design of the path for the robot to travel from the starting point to the destination point. These algorithms must consider the position of any obstacle to avoid collision and motion capabilities of the robot used for the mission. And the trajectory following defines the operations needed to keep the robot closer to the reference trajectory defined in the navigation phase. Classical or modern control rules can be used depending on the platform and environment characteristics. The path planning algorithms are classified into two categories. These categories are the classical algorithms and the heuristic methods. We are work in the classic algorithms, which include a modification of the probabilistic roadmap. Okay. The probabilistic roadmap consists in two phases, the learning and the query phase. In the learning phase, a network graph consists in nodes and connections distributed in the free space. And the query phase is a trajectory defined as a list of nodes with valid connection starting from an initial position and ending in the goal position is obtained. A valid connection is a connection between a pair of nodes with which the mobile robot can move in a straight line from one point to another point. In the figure one, the color blue is the learning phase, all the nodes and connection between the nodes. And the query phase is the red color to show the trajectory from the mobile robot. The proposed method consists in a learning, a query, and simplification, and the optimization phase. In the learning phase, the proposed implementation uses a high climbing approach by creating nodes only around the current position of the robot, P subscript I. In the figure two, I show the learning phase. In this case, the green lines show the valid connections and the red lines show the invalid connection between the current position of the robot and the target position of the robot. The next phase is the query phase. Due to the hill climbing is a local minimum optimization method, in a query phase, a random wall approach is used when the trajectory reaches a point where the distance to the goal position increases, no matter what connected node is selected. As you can see in the figure three, the trajectory is obtained with more nodes in the trajectory from the initial point to the final point. To simplify this trajectory, is proposed the next phase, that is the simplification. In this phase, consists to eliminate loops in the trajectory, and this is implemented by deleting from the trajectory all the intermediate position between any pair of position that can be reached using a valid connection. If you see the figure three and the figure four, the trajectory is lower. The next phase and the last is the optimization phase. In this phase, the proposed equation is to minimize the length of the trajectory L, which is defined as the sum of the distance between all points or consecutive points in the trajectory. Subject to the restriction that the connection must be valid. If you see the figure five, the final trajectory is lower than the figure four. For the simulation and the results, we are just some maps. In this case are 9 maps that I ordered by degree of difficulty due to the configuration of its obstacles. These maps are constructed by using ultrasonic and LIDAR sensors and using the SLAM key mapping algorithm. In this case, the comparison is using the both algorithms, the original PR method and the proposed algorithm called Smart Trajectory. Each map was tested 100 times. In both figures, the red line shows the PR method and the blue line shows the smart trajectory method. As you can see in both images, the peer method did not have values for all maps. This is because the peer method did not find a solution for every test. And in the case of the map 9, it was not able to find a solution. A quantitative comparison can be made using the statistics shown in the table 1. In this table, the percentage of success are shown for both algorithms. The smart trajectory has the 100% of success, and the peer method only in the map 1, in the map 4, and the 7 only have the 100% of success. And in the all maps, all restant maps didn't have. And for example, in the map 1, that the APOD method has the 100% of success, the mean of the distance in the smart trajectory is lower than the peer method. This is because the smart trajectory has the optimization phase that obtain the shortest distance to the from the initial to the final point. Both algorithms are configured to execute in the approximate same time. To show this trajectory obtained in a Simulink, a kinematic control is implemented for a differential mobile robot. In this case, the trajectory curves, it depends on the parameters of the robot. Okay, finally, in order to present a simulation in a more real environment, a test on an actual map is presented. The construction of the map has been carried out using the gazebo simulator in conjunction with the model of the robot Turtlebot 3. This map is a host of the same Turtlebot that carries a LiDAR sensor. This allows you to go around the scenario at mapping the entire area available. In both images is the same map, but in the left image, the query phase of the smart trajectory as shown from the initial to position point show the all the local minimum that the smart trajectory give. And the right image only show the final trajectory using a Simulink block diagram for the mobile robot. And it show that the trajectory is smooth and safely for the robot. Okay, the conclusion, the proposed algorithm calculates safe trajectories in no maps of different difficult levels. It generates shorter trajectories without increasing execution time with respect to the implementation of the peer method algorithm in MATLAB. The proposed algorithm generates safe trajectories with 100% of success rate for every map using in the comparison, unlike the PRM algorithm, which sometimes does not generate a solution. This depends on the position of the random node generated in the learning phase. In the figure 10, the Turtlebot 3 house is shown. This is the map that we use in the gazebo simulators. And this is a more real case for the robot and the smart trajectory algorithm. In the future work, The proposed algorithm will be implemented on a real robot using the ROS architecture till will be made possible to do comparison against algorithms that are using in the real robot instead of simulation environments. All the present work can be extrapolated to the three-dimensional maps to be implemented on aerial vehicles for exploration and mapping task. And this is all.
Thank you for your presentation. If anyone has a question, please, or a commentary, please put it in the chat. Okay. Okay. I just have a question. I don't know. Okay. This implementation, you only do it in MATLAB, right?
Okay. Yeah. Yes, in MATLAB.
Yes, and you always need a path that was traced before you do the optimization. In this case, yes.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And if you have a known map prior to this optimization, can you do a simulated trajectory and then optimize that? Or how will you do it now in ROS?
Oh, okay. In ROS, we use the map without a trajectory. The algorithm obtaining the initial and the final point. And the smart trajectory algorithm can be obtaining a trajectory in the four phases. In an optimization phase is the final path that the mobile robot uses for the in and out map. This is implemented in ROS using the same platform, Turtable Tree.
Okay. Yes, and you will do it experimentally, right? And not a previous phase with the simulated robot in ROS?
No, only the simulated robot in ROS, used for to obtain the map shown in the presentation, but not run the smart trajectory method.
Yeah, okay. Okay, thank you. Well, if no one has any questions. Oh, someone raise hand, Gerardo.
Okay.
In your example, did you quantify the computational resource used?
Sorry, I can't hear you very well.
In your example, did you quantify the computational resource user?
The result showing in the only the MATLAB, all the maps were tested in the laptop HP with an Intel Core i7.
How much memory or computer time?
Okay, the computer time is about the 0.3 seconds for both algorithms that show in the presentation in the table one.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, I will.
Okay. Someone has any other questions?
I think that's it. That's all.
Thank you, Omar, for your presentation. And we will continue with the next presentation. Thank you. Bye. Control and cable development of the third pivotal aircraft. Yes, the presentation ready?
Yes, the presentation is ready. Let me share.
Thank you.
Okay, you have
15 minutes. Thank you. Go ahead.
Hello, everyone. My name is Carlos, and I'm going to present a paper called Control and Cable Deployment of a Tether Pivotal Aircraft, written by Eduardo Espinosa, Rogelio Lozano, and by me. The presentation is structured as follows. First, a brief motivation. Second, a system description, the mathematical model. Third, the analysis of the catenary curve, which affects the aircraft dynamics. Next, the control architecture. Then, some simulation performed in MATLAB Simulink. And finally, conclusions and future directions. To start with, I'd like to talk about what a tether drone system is. As we know, multirotors are limited to short flight times due to their power system. One way to overcome this issue is to power them with a cable. This configuration allows them to fly for more than 10 hours. As the figure one shows, there's a multirotor tethered to a power station. And the figure two shows some of the application of the system. For example, we have defense, telecommunications, news gathering, humanitarian needs, private and public safety, and traffic monitoring. However, this tether configuration adds some issues to the flight dynamics, such as limited flight space and maneuvers. Also, an additional weight due to the power system. Our work focuses on how these cable weights affect the aircraft and what's the best way to deploy or retract the cable. We have the following goals. To deploy the deployment of a strategy to stabilize a pivotal power by a tether system. And then, given a position reference, the ground station computes the optimal cable length reference, which minimizes the tension force acting of the vehicle due to the cable weight. The figure 3 shows an sketch of the pivotal ground station system, which is composed by a single pivotal and a ground station. We continue with the model. The figure 4 shows the free body diagram of the system. And the questions 1 to 3 are the translational, the altitude, the rolling dynamics of the aircraft. And the question 4 stands for the winch or motor dynamics, which retract or deploy the cable to the aircraft. On equation 1 and 2, and we notice that there's a disturbance due to the cable weight, which is given by T cosine of phi and T sine of phi. Before we perform the tension analysis, first we need to define the catenary curve. A catenary is the curve assumed by a flexible cable hanging freely from two supports, in this case A and B, under its own weight. The figure 5 shows a catenary example with its parameters. In order to analyze the tension force, we use the catenary equations, which are given from equation 5 to 9. Most of these equations are functions of a parameter A, which is called the catenary parameter. So, given these equations, we perform the following analysis. First, between any two fixed points, we can have countless catenary curves as we vary the length of the tether. Among these curves, we kept the allowed curves as shown in the figure 6. So if the length L max is longer, the vertex, which is given by, in this case, the origin, is the length is larger, the catenary will be on the ground, but which is not realistic. So that's why we kept with all permissible curves. And for each curve, we have a different tension force acting on the aircraft. And we need to know which is the smallest. So we perform the following algorithm. And the idea behind this algorithm is the following. We fix one coordinate position of the aircraft, I mean X or Z, and we vary the left one. For example, we fix X and vary the altitude, or we fix the altitude and vary the translation. So at each position step, we analyze N catenary curves, let's say 10 or 20 catenary curves, and we kept with the one that minimizes the tension on the vehicle. The figure 7 shows this analysis, the analysis results. And from this method, we found that the length that minimizes the tension on the aircraft is the length called slack, which is the blue one given by the figure 6. Now we continue with the control system. The overall control system is shown in figure 8. We have the pivotal dynamics, the ground station dynamics or winch system, the local controllers, which are the attitude, the translational and vertical controller, and a subsystem which calculates the tension of the cable, and a reference position subsystem. So, to stabilize the system, we propose the following linear state feedback plus compensation laws, which are given from the equations 10 to 13. We notice that in equation 10 and 11 appears the compensation term, which is the t sine of phi, t cosine of phi, and t sine of phi. So these control laws guarantee the dynamics to converge asymptotically to the origin. For the simulations, first we define the reference system, which is given by a polynomial trajectory in order to have a smooth performance given by these equations. And at each time step, we need to compute the catenary parameter, which is A. So in order to calculate this parameter, we use the Newton-Raphson method because the equation is a transcendental one. And then we perform the following simulation. The figure 9 shows the simulation results, where we compare our proposed law, which is given by by the black one, with another similar but without the compensation terms, which is given by the blue one. As figure shows, the aircraft using without the compensation terms, the aircraft doesn't arrive to the final desired point of the trajectory. And when we use the compensation terms, we arrive to the final destination. We also perform a small animation. Let me show you. One moment, please. So this is the system, the control laws, the reference trajectory, and how these equations are connected by the block diagram. And we perform this using MATLAB Simulink, using the state feedback controller with attention compensation term for a trajectory tracking. And let's see, this is the vehicle, how is tracking the desired position given by the blue one, and how the catenary is deployed, and we see that we arrive to the final destination point, which is given by the red dot. And we also have the state response given by the figure 10, which shows the altitude, the position of the aircraft, the translation position of the aircraft, the tension on the aircraft, and the length, how it changed as the vehicles tracking the reference. And for the conclusions, we have the following ones. First, based on the tension analysis results, we can conclude that the minimization of the tension force in the vehicle by computing the optimal cable length was achieved. The computation of the desired length slack, which depends on the catenary curve parameters, by defining a desired vehicle position, was possible by using the proposed algorithm at each time step. Finally, the stabilization and trajectory tracking of the system dynamics was guaranteed despite the disturbance introduced to the system due to the tension force added by the power cable. And for future directions, we attempt to extend this work to multiple UA bits and also to build up the system. And that's all. Thank you so much.
Thank you for your presentation. If you have any questions or comments, you're welcome to write it in the chat. And I have a question. I know that this cable in the vehicle helps with the issue, the battery issues, right? You can connect it. And an advance in the experimental system that you can say for this particular UAV, you have this maximum length cable?
And yes, we were working with an experimental setup, but with the pandemic situation, we move on to the simulations. But on a real physical system, let's say like this one commercial, and how this is we transfer power to the vehicle, but we also can send data to the vehicle in a safety way. So this is one of the purposes using this system.
Okay, and just last question. Have you considered any protocol for this communication?
What device I didn't hear?
No. Which protocol? Like, I don't know. Internet, I don't know.
The classical UTP using an Ethernet cable. Okay. This is called PLC, power line communication.
Okay. Thank you. Anyone has another question? Okay. Okay. Then there is no more questions. And thank you so much for your presentation.
Thank you.
Okay, we continue with the autonomous navigation of mobile robot using network of Hind-Marash-Rose HR neurons.
Hello.
Hello. You can share your presentation, please.
Okay. Let me share the screen. Can you see?
I can see your PDF file. Yes. Okay. Now your presentation. Yes. You have 15 minutes. Please go ahead, Enrique.
Okay, I'll start. Hello, everyone, and welcome to this presentation about the project entitled Autonomous Navigation of a Mobile Robot Using a Network of Hind-Marash-Rose Neurons. My name is Enrique, and this project is directed by the doctors Alejandro Rodriguez and Jonathan Peña. The outline is the following: introduction, objective kinematic model, posture tracking, control based on neuronal model, numerical results, and finally, conclusions and future work. The study of the mobile robots is important because nowadays there are many applications about of them. Some examples are transporting objects in a factory, rural task, and unmanned exploration in a dangerous region. In these real applications, the mobile robots operate in an unknown environment. So the mobile robots must be sophisticated to recognize and to avoid obstacles and to do self-localization. In other words, the mobile robots must be smarter. And there is an interesting proposal for the autonomous navigation, which is control based on neuronal model. The objective for this project is to design and to implement a hybrid control using Hind-Marash-Rose neurons for autonomous navigation of a mobile robot on an unknown environment. This hybrid control is composed by a control based on neuronal model and a posture tracking control. This is because we want that the mobile robot generates a desired trajectory while it avoids obstacles. To start, we consider a type 2.0 differential mobile robot, which kinematic model is given in one. There is a coordinate X and Y that represents the position or center of the mobile robot. The kinematic model also has an orientation angle theta that is relative to the horizontal axis. The control inputs are the translational velocity V in this direction and the rotational velocity W. For the desired trajectory, we implemented the posture tracking control by Canudas. The tracking control is given in two. And that is U1 and U2 are functions of the state errors E1, E2, and E3. And they have tuning gains K1, K2, and K3. The task is to obtain the control inputs B and W or calculate given in three. And they are functions of the controls U1 and U2 and the reference velocities VR and WR. But in this work, we use the equations 4 and 5 that represent the right and left wheel speeds. R sub R is the wheel radius and VR is the distance between the wheels. How I said before, we consider the Hind-Marash-Rose model given in 6. It has three states, X is the member potential, Y is the recovery current, and Z is the adaptation current. The HR model has an input I, that is the external current, and all of the rest are constant parameters. The interesting of the HR model is that with a correct tuning of these parameters and the variation of the input I, we can obtain different modes or different responses on the member potential X. And these modes are spiking signals. And if the input I increases, and then the number of spikes on the member potential increases too, and vice versa. And we consider four neurons. The first two HR1 and HR2 are interconnected by a diffusive coupling. This diffusive coupling has a coupling force epsilon that is relatively small. And we use this diffusive coupling to take advantage of the minimum variation between the inputs I1 and I2 to generate different responses or different modes on the member potential X1 and X2. And we want to associate the member potential X1 with the left wheel speed and X2 with the right wheel speed. On the other hand, the HR3 and HR4 neurons are interconnected by a dynamic coupling. This dynamic coupling has a coupling force K, and this dynamic coupling, with this dynamic coupling, we can obtain a complete relaxing mode or a spiking mode on the member potential X4. And the transition from the complete relaxing mode to the spiking mode or vice versa is realized by this parameter G. G in this case is an exponential function in terms of the frontal sensor, but G is not in this presentation because time limits. But this this dynamic coupling and this parameter G, we can generate an strategy of frontal avoidance. Notice that the inputs I3 and I4 are the same and are constant. The control based on neuronal model is inspired on Broman, and the procedure is the following. First, we must do an orientation of 11 sensors. They are separated by 10 divided on 10 radians, pi divided on 10 radians, and the sensor frontal sensor is in the same direction of the translational velocity v. The next step is to obtain the minimum distance of the right sensors group of the left sensors group. And we have to obtain the reading of the frontal sensor. And finally, we have to obtain the minimum distance of all sensors group D. With this minimum distance, we can establish expressions for the inputs I1 and I2. These expressions are not in this presentation because limit times, but with this we can calculate the member potential X1 and X2, and after this calculate, we count the number of spikes on the member potential X1 and X2. And with this count, we can calculate the control based on the neural model by 9. The expressions 9 are the left and right wheel speeds. N1 and N2 are the counts of the number of spikes on X1 and X2. P is a turning gain, and X4A is the conditional member potential X4. That is, if the member potential X4 is on a spiking mode, then the value of X4A is equal to 1. But if the member potential X4 is on a complete relaxing mode, then the value of X4A is minus 1. And when the value of X4A is minus 1, then the direction of the right wheel speed is opposite to the left wheel speed. And this is the avoidance strategy. And on the other hand, the hybrid control is the switching or commutations between the control based on neuronal model and the posture tracking control. By 10 and 9, and the transition is in terms of D, remember, is the minimal distance of all sensors. For the numerical results, we make a simulation in the MATLAB Simulink environment. This simulation consists in two mobile robots inside of a rectangle area that has one entrance, one exit. The robot one is magenta and is programmed with the hybrid control. The robot two is blue and is only programmed with the control based on neuronal model. And well, the task is that the mobile robots have to get out of this rectangle area. And after this, specifically the robot one has to generate a desired trajectory. In this case, the desired trajectory is a circle with radius of 2 meters. where we put a static obstacle and for to prove the hybrid control performance. On the other hand, the robot 2 will navigate around of the rest of the map autonomously without collisions. Now I'll show you the animation of the simulation. We can see how the robot 1 and robot 2 didn't collide inside or outside of the rectangle area. And after this, the robot 1 tries to join to the desired trajectory until it is on the desired trajectory. Now the mobile robot detects and avoids the static obstacle. On the other hand, the robot 2 is navigating around of the rest of the map and didn't collide. And now the robot 1 is on the desired trajectory again, and another evasion is here. Okay, these graphs represent the an evolution of the membrane potential X1 and X2 of the robot 1. In this moment, in the first moment, we can see how the signal X1 and X2 are synchronized. That is, the number of spikes on X1 is the same as the number of spikes on X2. It means that the wheel speeds are the same, so the mobile robot moves in a straight line. But if we look at this in this moment, the membrane potential X1 is different to the membrane potential X2, and the wheel speeds are different. So the mobile robot turns to avoid an obstacle. Here we can see the wheel speed signals. In the first moment, we can see a variation of the wheel speeds. This is because the mobile robot is inside of the rectangle area. But after the exit, in this time, the mobile robot tries to join to the side trajectory, but it detects the static obstacle. And after the evasion of the obstacle, the mobile robot tries to join to the side trajectory. In this case, the mobile robot is on the desired trajectory, and the wheel speeds are constant. Specifically, the right wheel speed is little larger than the left wheel speed. This is because the mobile robot has to generate a circle trajectory. In this case, the mobile robot detects again the static obstacle, and it avoids it. And the cycle repeats again. For the conclusions, we have that the results show that the proposed controller has a good performance. This is because the mobile robot navigates autonomously without collisions and generate the trajectory desired trajectory. And well, to know this, we must have identical neurons. For future work, we want to implement the proposed obstacle avoidance scheme on Gazebo environment. This is because Gazebo environment is more real than the MATLAB Simulink environment. And we want to do an experimental validation. And that's all for me. Thank you.
Thank you, Enrique, for your presentation. Very interesting topic. If anyone has any questions, please write it on the chat, or if you want, you can open your mics, raise your hand. And I just have a question. It is all this you have it in MATLAB, right? And all the territories and the environment simulation is in MATLAB, right?
Yes.
Yes. Just a comment. I don't know. I know this is a simulation. I don't know if you can see the, I don't remember, the signals of the desired velocity in the wheels. Can you put it, please? Yes, that's right. This is I just have just a commentary. This is the algorithm, right? This is the output of your algorithm,
yes.
Right?
This is the input.
Well, the input to the robot, to the simulated robot, right?
Yes.
I don't know. These frequencies are always when you have these obstacles. Have you seen this? It's constant? Okay. Mm-hmm. And I don't know. If it's a high frequency, I don't know if for an experimental platform or in this case, the motor will be okay. Maybe you can. I don't know if you are considering this, because I see a lot of high frequencies in the input signal, right?
Yes, and we make experimental on the gazebo environment,
mm-hmm.
and the mobile robot and make the version correctly.
Yes, you can put then maybe a filter or something. You can do it. Yeah, well, it depends. Maybe the system reacts perfectly with these frequencies.
Yeah.
Maybe you need a filter, right? Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Yes. Thank you. Anyone has any other questions or commentary? Okay. Well, I think it's everything. Thank you for your presentation, Enrique.
Thank you.
And well, with this we finish the presentation from this room. Yep. And thank you to everyone for joining us and to be here with for this presentation. Thank you.